Hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I want to show you how to use Mendeley for your citation, your literature work, or in your articles for publication, or maybe you're writing your thesis, your project work for school, and want to manage your references. I'll be showing you how to use Mendeley to put up your references together and easily cite them in your work. So the first thing you would do is you go to mendeley.com, right? I assume that you have not installed the software or the app. So you go to mendeley.com here. You can easily create a free account, right? So before you do that, you can go to download. If you are using Windows, you click here, you download for Windows. If you are using Mac, you can download for Mac or Linux, any system you are using. So if you are using Windows, click on download. See that it's downloading already. Then you can register now for free. You can create an account, create a free account. Once you've created the account, right, create account, and you've done that, you can then go back to the software that you have just downloaded. Then you can install it. So I already installed the software on my system, so what I'll do is to open it, Mendeley Reference Manager, right? So here it is. So I already signed into this, but for you that just registered, what you do is, let me sign out, for instance. So if you just registered, you just enter your details here, your email address, then your password. When you click continue, to ask you to enter your password and all that. So I already have some references I've inserted here, but assuming you don't have any references yet, so what you do, there are ways you can start putting in references to your work. One of the ways to just come here, maybe you have a PDF file you have downloaded already on your system. You can go there, and import those files directly. Let's say you have those documents maybe somewhere here, say for instance this. You can easily click on it and you can see that will be imported into your document. You can see that it's imported here with the details. So once you click on that, you can see the informations for that paper. If you want to edit anything there, you can, but mostly it comes in good form. So, but basically what you have to do first is to go to tools. After you have logged in, you go to tools. You can still install Mendeley Web Importer and install Mendeley Cite for Microsoft Word. So this is the one you'll be using to cite in your Microsoft Word. And this one is what you can use to import references directly from web browser. When you are going through the paper, you don't need to download it first before you can add it to your reference. You can directly import it to Mendeley. So now if you click on that, it takes you here. So basically you can only add it to, you can get Web Importer for Edge. So if you are using Microsoft Edge, you can click get Web Importer for Edge. You can see that get, and then add extension. So you can, once you click on add extension, it's doing that. Extension has been added here. You can see that. So for instance, now if I'm browsing a paper, let me go to Google Scholar. So if you go to Google Scholar, for instance, and let's say you want to search autonomous vehicle driving, so you can see different articles on the autonomous driving. So if I click on that one, so this one, now I can view it as PDF, or I can cite it. Let me see. If I click on cite this, you can see here this one doesn't have where to import it directly, because mostly the papers that the journals that have direct import are Elsevier journals mostly, because Mendeley works with Elsevier basically. So but another way you can do this is to click on cite this, so you can either import it as beep test or raise. So if I click on beep test, I can download it as beep test. So once you downloaded that, now you can then go back to here and you can click add, import from library, beep test, and the one I just downloaded, now download, you can see it here, this is the one I just downloaded, click on it, open, so it will automatically add it. You can see it's already added it here now. So now let's look at if we can get a paper that we can import directly. Let me see. Let me just put Elsevier. So now you can see I have put Elsevier there now. Now if you look here, you can see add to Mendeley. This one have add to Mendeley. So if I click add to Mendeley, it will ask me to sign in. So I'll just sign in. So once I sign in now, that's brought that article, autonomous driving in the ICT. So this is it. If I have other paper, maybe I want to add this one, so I can select them and select all paper that I want to add. But if it's just the first one I want to add, I will select only the first one and then, you know, click on add. Then maybe you have created some libraries, you want to add it to a specific library. You can select that library. Let me say, I want to add it to Media Buyers, for instance. I'll just select Media Buyers and click add. Right, so once I click add, it already added it to that. So if I go to Mendeley now, you can see it's already added. So if I go to Media Buyers, it will be the first paper you can see there. So that's that. I've added that to my paper. So the next thing now is to go back to Mendeley and go to tools. You can see install Mendeley site for Microsoft Word. So if I click on that, to take me here, I say okay, get it now. I click on get it now, accept, continue, taking you to Microsoft 365 to complete this process. So to bring me here, open in Word, you can see already I have that installed in Word. So if I haven't, it will bring something like this, references, site with Mendeley. Already I have that installed in Word. So what will happen is once I go to references, I can see the icon here, Mendeley site. But there are some worse version that this icon will not appear here automatically. But if you didn't see the icon here, what you do is go to insert, go to my add-ins. So you see it under my add-ins. So you can click on it, add. So it will appear here. So once you do that, you will see it. So my own there is already there automatically. So now let me say this is the paper I want to cite. I've added all my references as required. So I have to sign in here again. So after I've signed in, right, it will bring all my references here. So you can always like update from library. Let's say you just added new ones in your library, you can update it. So you have all the new references here. So once you have the references here, you can start to cite. Let's say you want to cite here, survey. Let's say you want to cite these two papers. You can just position your cursor where you want the citation to be in your paper, and then select it, select the two papers or more, or one, depending on the number of citation you want to add, and click insert the two citation. You can see the two has been inserted there. Now let's say you have multiple citations, and let me say I want to insert another one here, and you know there are a lot of them here and I can't start scrolling through to know which one I want to you can search by keywords. You know, maybe you know a keyword in all one of the name of the authors. You can search. Let me say I want to search with crash auto. So you can see auto crash, autonomous crashes. So this is one of the papers. So if you know, you can search with either any keyword in the title of that paper or the name of the author. So anyone you know, you can use it to search it easily. Once you enter it to select that, so you can add that. Then maybe I want to add another references here. I'll just go back here, clear this, then scroll down. Maybe I know the name of the author, let's say, then master. So let's say maybe I have Adan So yeah, so whatever name you know, you can use that. Let me say I want to add this one, just I'll just click insert. So I've added those two now. Now after adding your reference, your citation, you want to show all the reference you have used, and just go to where you want to insert your references and then go to insert bibliography. So once you click on insert bibliography, continue, you can see all your bibliographies are inserted here. So you can name it references, depending on how you want that. So you have it here. And the last thing is citation style. So you can always change your citation style. So once you come to here, these are some citation style that are already here. You know, your Sylvia with numeric with titles, updates. You can see it changes to numbers. If you go to your where you cited them, you see that it has also changed to numbers 3 and 4, 3, 1 and 2, like that. So, and if you have a particular style you want to use and it's not here, you can always select another style. Let's say you know the name of that style, APA, for instance. Let's say, okay, I want to use APA, whatever APA I want to use, Taylor Francis APA, University College APA. Click on it, update. Automatically, it will update your references. So that's basically how to use Mendeley in your work. So if you have any question, just ask, and I will be here to attend to them. Thank you.